Okay, hello. Can you hear me? Yeah, I think it's time to start. So welcome. My name is Grzegorz Ożniecki, and I will present you a quickie about the seven sins of optional. So a caveat here, this talk is a quickie, as I said, and there will be some speed running here. So if you have any questions, please ask them after the talk. And another one, very important, this talk actually has two parts, and please be sure that you are on both, because the first wouldn't make sense with the second one. So let's do a quick introduction to optional. What actually is an optional? But before that, let's say that designing optional was the hard part for the JDK developers. It was like flame wars on the Lambda dev list and many, many, many places over the internet. So there will be some, you know, flame wars here also. But as I said, just wait for the end. And Brian Goetz is a lead architect from Oracle, so he's the guy who knows things. So what's optional? Actually, optional is... Oh, it doesn't work. Oh, yeah. It's an easy concept, yeah? Because it's just a monad, which is a, as you can see, a monoid in the category of endofunctors. So what's the problem? So the problem is that the optional in JDK wasn't introduced because it should be a monad here, but because the guys needed some return result type for some stream operations like find first, yeah? So the name of optional is actually kind of weird here. It really should be named as a optional result or maybe result. And there is this guy, Stephen Colburn. He's a author of JODATime, the framework which was used before JavaTime was in JDK 8, and actually he also designed the JDK 8 JavaTime package. So he's the guy who's also involved in some JSRs. And he said basically that because this is an optional result, it should be named as such, and it would lead to less overuses of the API. And because naming is hard, the guys said, it's maybe too late, or it doesn't matter, naming is hard, let's leave it as optional. Okay, so next one is actually the naming of the get method. Yeah, the second thing is that the get method should really be named differently. How should it be named? And Brian has also told us about this should be like get or else throw no such element exception, or even worse. Why? Because this is what it does. It's actually just like the null check. When you do the null check, it throws a null pointer exceptions. Here, the exception is different. And the get is such a, you know, little small get method. It looks nice. I should use it. Like the first method in this API, get is the greatest one. Well, it isn't. So, yeah. So it also should be deprecated. Why? Again, maybe I'll switch to this. Again, Brian Goetz, he's the lead architect from Oracle again. He said that in 2016, let's see, that the method itself should be deprecated, but they didn't do this, and they won't do this because there is too much usage for this method. But nevertheless, if they thought about this earlier, it could really be seen as a deprecated from the beginning method. Yeah? Yeah, this is a feature. But one more thing. Optional is a library thing, yeah? It's not a language feature. Do you know any language which has a better null type safety? Do you know what language this is? Yeah? Anyone? Kotlin, yeah, exactly. So Kotlin does it right. When you see this null safety documentation page, reference page, you will see that there is, by design, the language by design has a null as a type of, like, a subtype. So for example, let's see this as an example. When you have a string and declare it as a var a is a string and define it as abc, and you try to assign it null, it's a compilation error. It does not compile. Why? Because there is a special string with a quote, which is a nullable type, and assigning null to this is okay. It does not, it compiles okay. So it's very clear from the beginning what author wants here. Okay? And there is also some language features like this operator, which assures that there are no null pointer exceptions here. Like, for example, here, if either Bob, department, or head are null, the result will be null. Otherwise, it will be the name of the head of the department from Bob. Okay? Another thing, like in Kotlin, for example, there is this Elvis operator, which assures that the default value can be, you know, assigned very, very easily without any, you know, if-else stuff. Also, there is, do you know what this means? Anyone? Yeah, it explicitly throws null pointer exception. Yeah, if you want, it could throw, but it's, you know, not very encouraged. And the last one, because of this is a language feature, you can define the list of nullable integers, like here, and you have a method for like filter one tool, which copies the list to the list of non-nullable ints. So it's very safe, yeah? Kotlin does it right. Why would Java won't do this right? Yeah, the thing is that it's a library thing, not a language thing. Okay, let's live with this. So because it's a library thing, it should be a value type. It is declared as a value type, but what does it mean? What does it mean to have a value type? Do you know? It's a small immutable identity-less thing. Like integer is a value type for int. It does not have any identity. It could be equal in terms of identity to another instance of the same integer, like 127 or maybe 128, if you know what I mean. It could be equal, but it should not be because it's a value type. I'm speaking about integer. So the thing is that there are plans to include the value types in JDK, like maybe in, I don't know, Java 10 or later. And there is this document state of values. You should read it definitely, which says about this. Okay. Another sin of the optional design of optional is that it's not serializable. And Guava's one is actually serializable. You can put it in the field of the class, and if a class is serializable, it won't throw any weird exceptions, okay? Yeah, implementing serializable is hard, and Brian Goetz says that, yeah, it's a maintenance cost, blah, 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 blah. They didn't do it, and it was by design. Okay, let's move on to the seventh sin, okay? So optional, as I said, isn't useful in fields, in collections, in parameters, in error handling. And this is all true, but there is one but. What if I told you that everything I said, those seven sins, are not entirely correct? They are not correct at all. Because I think that optional as a library addition was designed very well, as long as you use it properly. So the real topic of this presentation should be the seven sins of optional users. And why would you use optional only correctly? Yeah, you should know when to use the optional here, okay? So this part will be about misusages of optional. There will be code, there will be smells here, okay? So people think, okay, so we have optional, yeah? So we should abandon null entirely, yeah? And use optional everywhere. And it's basically, it's an opinion of some people like Doug Lee, who basically implemented whole Java util concurrent package, and also Tony Hoar, who created it now in the first place for Algo a couple of years ago, like 40 years ago. And those people say that null smells, yeah? So people do this in Java 8. And what this code does? What this code do? So this basically does the same as the old school null check. And people should not be afraid of null checks like this, the second one. And I personally think that this is like the greatest sin of all, that people put optional everywhere. Like, because, oh, this is method reference here in the first example. Yeah, but why? it shouldn't be used like this. Also, as I said in the first part of my presentation, get is like unwrapping null reference. The difference is the exception is different, okay? So you should never use get alone. And there are other options in API like map, filter, flat map. You should know them before you start using optional because it wouldn't be much more clear what you wanted to do without those operations. There is also or else, or else get, or else throw. And they are also misused. So instead of this, for example, if you are very certain that the get is not a empty optional, you should throw some meaningful exception. Also, this example is like the shorthand version. You should put some message like, my code should not produce an empty optional here on this branch of my ifs, blah, blah, blah. Or maybe you are using, split, which has, pattern in JDK has method split, which returns a stream, the new method in Java 8. And it returns also, obviously, a stream with one or more elements. So the find first would always find at least one element, okay? So the next thing, the third thing people do, is they are only using the subset of API. It's basically the same as previous slide, but there is more that than being safe, than using get, and before using get, you use is present. Because when use is present, using get is safe. So the previous slide is invalid in terms of that you are unsafe, yeah? But you should avoid this combo of these two, unless you're not on Java 9, because currently you have to write this example, and in Java 9 there will be some addition like if present or else, which will be easier. Right now, this is the way to do the stuff like find me some user, and if it's present, do some work, and otherwise log, for example, that this was not found, okay? This is the current approach. In Java 9, there will be a nice handy method for this, okay? Another more complicated, maybe not more complicated, fine example, which will be easier in JDK 9, currently, you have to filter some stream of optionals this way, and there will be a method optional stream added to optional, which would allow you to flat map just a stream of optionals like it would be a collection of either zero or one elements. Okay. Also, people are using optional as preconditions, like similar to the first example. As I say again, optional should be used only as a result, not like this. Optional of new label full, if present, sorry, this should be, or else throw, this is a typo, okay? Optional of new label full, or else throw, legal argument exception, because there is like the method for this, in like for example Guava, which is called checked not null. You can import it statically, and this is a meaningful, this has a meaning that this is a precondition, it should be thrown. And also, this is not the same as the first example, but I'm very convenient that in terms of checking nulls, I should throw null pointer exceptions. It's another framework, not for this presentation. But so the fifth sin of optional users is that they combo optionals. I mean, combine optionals of optionals. For example, what does this do? Like you have some big decimal, a first and second big decimal. Okay, so these are optionals of big decimal. First and second are optional of big decimal. And you map the first, you map the add for the second. What does it? Okay, so this is basically the same. It's much more clear using plain old ifs and checking whether this this first if checks whether they are both present, not present, and the result is empty otherwise. And the second one, if either of these is present, just do the addition. Okay, it's easier. Also, using optional in fields and parameters. I said during the first presentation, which was obviously not valid point, that optional should be used, should be serializable. It shouldn't. It's actually not serializable by design. It is Guava version has implement serializable, but this is a design mistake. And Guava devs admitted that if they did it again, it wouldn't be serializable. So the whole point of optional is actually here is actually well defined here by Stuart Marks, who is another Oracle JDK dev, that this should be only produced and immediately consumed. Like if it's present, do something; otherwise, do something. And the API should only help you to do this. One particular thing, okay? What's more, this is the example what you shouldn't do. So you shouldn't store optional as a field. Basically, you have to store the plain nullable field and wrap it in, like for example, getter here with optional reference. Also, nullable here is a annotation, and annotation is also not on a language level. It's only a hint for some libraries like check style or other things. That this should be nullable some time. Okay. Also about using optional in collections, this leads to some weird constructs like map of optional of list of optional strings. Generally, you should never do this. You should use empty collection, empty map in places when you want some empty things. When you have list of optional strings, you probably wanted a list of nullable strings. Because optional is just an object, you don't wrap in optional. Basically, it's not for that. Okay. Also, there's a bonus. There's a change in documentation in JDK 9. In optional documentation, it says basically all I said before. It will be written black on white in the Java doc that optional is used as a result, and also the get method should not be used directly. There are many alternatives to that. Okay. There is also like optional is used somehow sometime for like exception handling. There is this small project TriMonad, which basically has the same API as optional, but is used for either result or throwable occurred during some operation. Okay, so the other thing is So basically, that's all. One thing I had to say is that I based this talk on the Stuart Marks optional, the mother of all bike sheds presentation, which was given by him on VJAC some time ago. And the seven sins are basically the things he said about this. So there is also these other resources you should read. And that's all. Thank you. If you have any questions, just come to me. And enjoy your lunch. Bye.